and those who think you judge us and wrong spot, and those who redeem the evil for good side of me, because I pursue righteousness, and it's only way one of those other mercy works, and not forsake me, Lord my God, do not depart from me, if you tell me Lord my salvation. Do not forsake me, Lord my God, do not depart from me, if you tell me Lord my salvation. O God, my God, I rise early to be with you, my soul thirsts for you, and all my flesh thirsts for you, and the desolate passage of my life is silent. So in the holy place I appear before you to see your power and glory of God. Because your mercy is better than light, my life shall praise you. Bless and bless you, my life, with my hands in your name. May my soul be filled as if with my own fatness, and my mouth shall sing praises to you, filled with lips filled with rejoicing. If I remember you, my God, I praise you that will be great, for you are my helper, and in the shelter of your wings I will greatly rejoice. My soul falls in this covenant, great and takes hold of me. But they seek for my soul, being that shall go into the lowest parts of the earth. They shall be given over to the edge of the sword, they shall be a portion for foxes. But their king shall be God, and God in all his heart, by whom shall be greatest, and all that speaks on anxious things is stopped. And meditate on your daybreak, for you are my helper and the shelter of your wings, all great and rejoices. My soul falls close behind your great and takes hold of me. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, and to the age of the men. Alleluia, 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 glory to your God. Alleluia, 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 glory to your God. Alleluia, 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 glory to your God. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, to the Son, to the Holy Spirit, now to the age of ages. Amen.
Κύριε, ο Θεός της σωτηρίας μου, ημέρα της έκλεψα, εν ηθήν ο Θεός μου. Εις αυτά τον Άγιον σου προσευχή μου, πριν ως λόγους σου εις εντεύξεις, ότι ευρίστηκα ακόμη ψυχή μου και η ζωή μου το άδειο μισέ. Προσελογίστην ήταν ο κατεμένος μας μέσα από την ενήθεια μας οι άνθρωπος από εκεί τόσο σαν νεκρής ελάχιστος. Όσοι τράβουν αντία κατέβα στην τάφο, μη στη σέτη και αυτή ατεσχερό σου απόσπισαν. Πέθεντο με ο άλλο, κάτω τάφο να σκοτεινείς και εις για αυτά. Επεμπέντε στρίχθη μου όσο και πάνω του συνεδριορισμού σου αιτία εις επεμένου. Και μάκρυνα στους γνωστούς μου αφημού εθελών μου που έχουν τελείμα τα λεαφτήσει. Χωρεδόθη και όλοι τους χωρικό θέμι, το μη μου είναι στην εισαναποκτωχία σου. Εκέκραξα προς έγκυρη όλη την ημέρα διαπέτασα προς τα σχήρα σου. Μη της νεκρής κλίσης θα δημάσαι αεία, τι να στήσουν και εξημόγησουν τέσσου. Μη διηγήσετε τις ελτάφα το έργο σου και διαδίωσουν τη απομία. Μη γνώσουστε έντος ότι τα δαγμάσια σου και η δικαιοσύνη σου είναι επιλεγισμένη. Καγώ προσεχή και έκραξα και το πρωί προσεχή μου προφτάσισε. Είναι αντίκη η απόφητη ψυχή μου, όπως τρέψε στο πρόσωπό σου αδερμού, στο πόσο βαρυμίκε μου πεις, εκνιώθει το όσο νεπιστοπή, δεν θα δυνάθει και εις πολίτη μου. Επεμέζει ήρθαν οι οργές σου εκπομπές μέσω εξετάραξε με. Κύκλος αν με όσοι άκρη όλη την ημέρα περιέσουν μια άμα. Εμάχνα σε θεμού φιλών και πλησίων και τους γνωστούς μου από τα λεπορία σου. Κύριε ο Θεός σου θρύλες μου ημέρα σε διέκραξα και εν ηθήν αντίον σου. Εις αυτά τον οποίον σου προσευχή μου που τον τούγω σου στην πλήση μου. Ευλόγη η ψυχή μου τον Κύριο και πάντα θεμός μου το όνομα του Άγιον αυτού. Ευλόγη η ψυχή μου τον Κύριο και μη επιλάθω πάσα στα σαν τα αποδόσεις αυτού. Τον επιλατεύω τα πάσα στα σαν σμία σου. Των ηγούμενων πάσων στους στόχους σου, των βιτούμενων εκφορά στην ζωή σου, των στεφανούντα σύνοδο και εκτελεί. Των εμιμώντα να κατήσει την επιθυμία σου, να κινήσει σε όσα η τμήματή σου. Ποιόν, ελεημοσύνο ο κύριο και την παπά τη αστυνομία. Ευμόρισε τα σώτου αυτό το νησί, τη σκιή τη ζαϊού τα θύματα. Δικτύβουν και ελεήμουν ο κύριο, μακρόθυμο και πολύεκρο, που και στέλο ορμήσε θεοδέη στην μόνη μου. Που κατά την αδημία κατά τη νομία ημών επίση μη, που δεν κατά τι αμαρτίε ημών ανταπέδω και μη, ό,τι κατά το ύψο του ουρανού τη γη εκτατεί ω ο κύριο και ο ρεσό του δεκτοσκοπημένου αυτών. Καθώ ον απέκρουσε με τα τολέα χωρισμού, και μάχημα αδημών τα αμαρτία ημών. Καθώ η κτήρη πατήρη ούσο κτήρη ο κύριο τη κοπημένου αυτών. Ότι αυτό έχω το πλάσμα ημών εμνήσει ο δικούσε άνθρωπο. Πως σηκώτωσε η μέρα αυτός οι άνθρωποι στον οποίο τους εξαμφίσει. Ότι πνεύμα βίωθουνε με αυτό και ούτε ξυπάρχει και ούτε επιγνώσετε επί των τόπων αυτών. Το δελεύος του κυρίου του αιώνος και έως του αιώνος σε τους σχολουμένους αυτών. Και η δικαιοσύνη αυτού επί ίσιών της κυλάσσου του διαθήκεν αυτού και με επιμένει στον ευρών αυτού του ποιήσε αυτάς. Κύριος εν του ουρανού εκεί μας τον θρόνο αυτού και η βασιλεία αυτού πάγοντες πόζει. Ευλογείτε τον Κύριο πάντες οι αγγελία του, δυνατοί οι ισχύοι πηγούντες στον λόγο αυτού, του ακούσε τη φωνή στον λόγο αυτού. Ευλογείτε τον Κύριο πάση ετοιμάνωση αυτού, λειτουργεί αυτού πηγούντες του θέλημα αυτού. Ευλογείτε τον Κύριο πάντα τα έργα αυτού, εν παντή τόπο της δεσποτείας αυτού, ευλόγη εν πανίδ όπως δεσποτείωσε αυτού εγώ η γύψη του μονοπίου. Κύριε, εισάκουσον τους προσευχείς μου, εν πόντισε την δέησή μου και λυθία σου, εισάκουσον την δικαίωσή σου. Και μη είσαι όφε εσείς φύση μετά το δικό σου, ότι μου δικαιωθήσεις ενώπιον σου πάσο, ότι κατεδίωξε ο εχθρός του ψυχή μου μεταπείνωσε εν εισήν τη ζωή μου. Εκάθισε με σκοτεινήσε ως νεκρούς εγώς και κυρίες με το πνεύμα μου, εν εμή εταράπτη η κυρία μου. Μίση ημερών αρχαίων μελέτησα εν πάση της έδωσης και είμαστε τον χειμό σου επαναλήτων. Διεπέτρεψα προς τα σχήρα σου η ψυχή μου ως μια γλώσσα. Τα αρχή εις άκουσα μου, Κύριε, ξέρετε το πνεύμα μου. Μη αποστρέψεις το πρόσωπό σου από μου και ομοιωθήσουμε τις κατεβαίνες του φάγμα μου. Ακουστών πίσω από το πρωί το ωραίο σου και επισέλιωτησα. Γνώρισον, Κύριε, τον διαφοράσουμε, ότι προσεγείρα την ψυχή μου. Εξελούμε τον εχθρό μου, Κύριε, προς τα κατεύθυνα μου. Δίδαξον με την πίνη του θερμά σου, ότι εσύ ή ο Θεός μου, το πνεύμα σου το αγαθό να οδηγήσει με την ευθεία. Ένα και το όνομα σου, Κύριε, ζήσεις μου. Εν τη δικαιοσύνη σου εξάσεις, εθέψεως την ψυχή μου. Και εν το ευρύνη σου, εξοδοφεύσεις τους εχθρούς μου. Και απολύς πάντας τους τρίπτος την ψυχή μου, ότι εγώ, ούτω σου μη. Εισάκουσον μου, Κύριε, τη δικαιοσύνη σου. Και μη σε άφησες κρίση μετά το τόπο σου. Εισάκουσον μου, Κύριε, τη δικαιοσύνη σου. Και μη σε άφησες κρίση μετά το τόπο σου. Το πνεύμα σου το αγαθό να οδηγήσει με μια ευθεία. Δόξα ταυτή και εγώ και αγίω πνεύμα τη. Και μην και αεί και στους αιώνας του αιώνα να μην. Αλληλούια, 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 δόξα στον Θεό. Αλληλούια, 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 δόξα στον Θεό. Αλληλούια, 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 δόξα στον Θεό.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Everything that hath breath below.
O Lord, raise up your heart.
because of the faithful pursuit of God and your power, grant the moment of victories against your adversaries. And for now, my Lord, may they have your peace as their armor that shall be invincible.
And the God of all things.
My love, life restored, Christ God, have resurrected with his good divine hand, and the lips of caverns, all of that from eternity, he freely bestowed resurrection on the substance of our mortal humanity. Praise the Savior of all resurrection and life, and thy God of all things.
And the God of all things.
Your cross and tomb, O life giver, we believers worship and seek grace. For hell, O you who live forever as Almighty God, you must believe. The gates of hell have been torn to shine sin as God, the mind of man, the face. So abundantly we are born, praise and exalt you, the one who now reigns, who destroyed the deadly power of our foe. You have resurrected everyone, all those who believe in you. You have rescued the world from certain things, and have snatched us from the words of us alone, as you alone had the ability to do so. Hence we piously sing the praises of your rising, by which you saved us as the God of all things.
And the God of all things.
On September 20th, we commemorate the holy day for you, Sophius and his wife, Theopates, and their two sons, Agapius and Theopistus. On this day, we commemorate our holy fathers, Theopius, the bishop, and Andrew, the president of the confessors. On this day, we commemorate the saints, Martyr, Martin, Patriarch of Rome, Maximus, and those with them. On this day, we commemorate the holy martyrs, Antonius and Thales. On this day, we commemorate the godfather, Valentius, bishop of Cyprus. We also commemorate John the Egyptian, the great confessor, the new monastic martyr, Hilarion, the king of the East Constantinople, the year 1804, and died by the sword. By the intercession of the saints of God, have mercy on us. Amen.
In the Gospel of Thomas, the name of the Aegean, the Maraud Martyrs, the Santé, and the Pistis, sin viu αυτόν και τον δύο αιώνα αυτόν αγαπητοί Θεοπίστου. Και αυτή η μέρα μείνει των Αγίων Πατέρων Ιμών και Απολογητών, Ιπατίου, Επισκόπου και Ανδρέου Πρεσβυτέρου. Και αυτή η μέρα μείνει των Αγίων Μαρτίνου, Πάπα Ρώμης Μαξίμου και των Συναφής. Και αυτή η μέρα μείνει των Αγίων Μαρτίνων Αρχιμίδωρων και Θαλού. Και αυτή η μέρα μείνει του Οσίου Πατρός Ιμών Βενετίου Επισκόπου Κύπρου. Και μείνει της του ομολογητές Αγίας του Ιωάννου της Ιγύπτου. Ο Άγιος Νέος και ο Μάρτυρος Ιλαρίων Χρυς, ο εν Κωνσταντινούπολη μαρτυρής σας, κατά το έτος 1024, ξύνει και λίγο. Θες αυτόν Αγίας Πρεσβείας Θεός, ελέησον ημάς, αμήν. Oh,
Of your compassion, but all my saints, my mother, Lord.
the mercy and compassion and love of mankind, your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed, together with your all holy good and life giving Spirit, now and forever, to the ages of ages.
All good.
Oh. Thank you.
While they were perplexed about
What sign it is now, the thing is it in me, and not talking so
much. Doxa patri Dei, o que aqui eu tenho a vida.
Thank you. Thank you.
Χριστού και ούκ εξ έργων νόμου, διότι εξ έργων νόμου ούτε και οφείσαι σε πάσα άρση. Ήδε ζητούνται στη Θεοτήνα εν Χριστώ ευρύθμε και αυτή αμαρτωλή. Άρα Χριστός αμαρτίας διάγνωρος μη γέννηται. Ήγα να κατέληξα ταύτα πάλι του εγώ, καναβάτην εν αυτόν συγκίνηση. Εγώ γάρδια νόμου, νόμου απέθανο είναι ο Θεός Ιησού. Χριστό, συνεστάβομαι, ζω δε μου και τι εγώ, ζήτε εν εμή Χριστός. Ο δε μην ζω εν σαρκή, εν πίστη ζω, και του Υιού του Θεού, του αγαπήσοντας με.
Peace be with you, the readers.
And I
am.
God, what a blessing it is to be here today. I'm Father Nate Daniel. I'm the assistant and annunciation actor with Father Jerry Hall. And as you all know, Father Nate is not available at the moment. We'll get into that after the service. But I'd just like to offer a few words, and I'll give you some context, because this is going to be a little different from what you're used to. I'm not going to preach on the gospel today, because in prepared this week, back in Annunciation and Advent, we're actually doing a sermon series about how to have a deeper Christian faith. And so I was going to offer the first part of that. And I'm going to offer it to you all today, because it's important. And I think it's life-giving and edifying. And so I hope you find it useful. I'm going to start off in a non-conventional way, but I'd like you to indulge me for a moment. And if all of you that have been to Camp Mass understand one thing that's important, it's quiet time. And I'll say, in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, because I'm about to preach. I'd like to begin this sermon with a moment, 30 seconds of stillness. 30 seconds of silence. 30 seconds of prayer. And then I will continue. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Thank you for your indulgence. I promise it hasn't been. I remember when I graduated seminary, I was actually classmates with Dear Sava over here for a little while. I graduated in 2019, and people would always ask me, what did you learn most from seminary? What was it that stuck with you? And I'd always tell people, it's not what you learn, but it's who you become. At seminary. It's not what you learn. Anyone can read books and theology and tenets of our dogmas and anything. It doesn't take a master's to do that, right? But it's who you become at the seminary that's special. And I think as Orthodox Christians today, a lot of us have this same mentality. We all want to have this idea, this knowledge of God. We want to learn about God through books, through theology, through the correct moral choice, through the correct ethical values. And then we grade our world and our atmosphere through these ethics, through these ideas of what it means for us to be a good Orthodox Christian. And I think when we do this, it's almost as if we're starting at the end rather than the beginning. Our starting point is incorrect. We're asking the wrong question. I think a lot of us ask the question of, well, I'll know God if I know the dogmas of the faith, if I know all the icons and all the saints, or if I know, you know, what it means to be in the church and what it means to be a Christian and ecclesia, you know, whatever it may be, example after example after example. It's almost as if we're starting to try and build a house on the roof first. When you build a house, you have to lay a foundation. You have to lay a base for the house to sit upon. And in the same way, we have to lay a foundation for our relationship with Christ. We don't come to know Christ in a personal, dynamic, and beautiful way through reading books or studying our theology and our dogma. We come to know God through stillness. And you can find this in Scripture.
And so I would go to Scripture. One of my favorite quotes in all the Bible is Psalm 46:10, which is, "Be still and know that I am God. Be still and know that I am God." This is our coming to know Christ. This is our foundation in which we build upon our house. Stillness and silence. It goes on. There's a really wonderful and dynamic example that I'd like to share with you in 1 Kings chapter 19. And it's, we come to the prophet Elijah in the Old Testament. And Elijah had just called down fire from heaven and demonstrated the Lord's sovereign might. Elijah was then persecuted. And so the pagan queen Jezebel promised to hunt down and kill Elijah, which caused Elijah to fall into despair, as many would. He feared that he was the only person in Israel who still had faith in the Lord. Elijah believed that everyone had fallen into idolatry except for him. Elijah believed that God was there, but he began to doubt. He began to doubt that God would be victorious, that God would triumph. He began to doubt that the demons and the idolaters would overtake Israel. So, with great despair, Elijah cries out to God and asks to die. But God doesn't request, he doesn't grant that request. He says, instead, go up upon a mountain, and there God feeds him water and food and sustenance to eat and drink. And there Elijah encounters something very mysterious. And it's a beautiful image. He encounters three things. First, a great wind blows across the mountain, so strong that the mountain splits and breaks rocks. But the scripture says that God was not in that great gust. Then Elijah experiences a powerful earthquake, shaking the rocks and striking the mountains where he stands. But again, scripture says that God was not in the earthquake. Then finally, a great fire consumes the mountainside, and there's tumultuous heat coming all about. And it says that God was not present in the fire. Three separate mind-blowing events: a great wind, a striking earthquake, and a tumultuous heat Elijah experiences, but God was not there. And then it takes an obscure turn. The scripture says that after all of these three things, Elijah heard a still, small voice. God was present in that still, small voice. I think a lot of us, when we think about coming to know Christ, we think about some momentous occasion where the heavens will open up and God will say, "Glory to you, my good and faithful servant, X, Y, and Z, your name in place here." When in reality, God doesn't meet us in that way. He might in miraculous occasions, I'm not saying he doesn't, but for most of the time, for most of us, he meets us in that stillness and in that quiet. And so I'd just like to talk about, why do we struggle to be still? If you've ever tried to be still and silent and quiet, think about what happens. Reflect upon how you react. It's very interesting. Many of us react in an obtuse way, in a way that we feel almost scatterbrained. We can't handle it. We feel at friction. We feel very tense. A lot of us can't relax and be still and silent. So many of us are so hooked, me specifically, are so hooked to our technology and to our laptops or my phone or whatever it may be, that we can't put aside our possessions or whatever it may be. Maybe it's not a phone, maybe it's something else for you that's a distraction, right? It might not be a phone, but for me, I'm talking for myself. So what happens? St. John Chrysostom says, that when we try to be still, we rouse the snake within us. We rouse the snake within us, which I find a really beautiful quote. What does this mean exactly? In other words, we're almost poking the inner world of our heart. All of that darkness and negativity, all of our thoughts and anxieties, our depressions, our doubts, our stresses, all of those things we compartmentalize. And when we're still, it's almost as if we're opening up that band-aid and seeing our cut for what it is, seeing our woundedness for what it is. And many of us can't stand to be in that presence of that woundedness. But it's in that woundedness where we meet Christ. It's in that meekness and that weakness that we meet Christ. It's not in a shout of glory upon a mountaintop, but it's in that still, small voice in our heart, in our weakness, and in our inner world. And so, the next time you try, I encourage all of you, this is the first step to having a deeper Christian faith, is stillness, is acquiring a stillness, a solitude, a silence, not just around us, but within us. So if we really want to come to know Christ, we want to come to know Jesus, our Savior, we should take that step of being still and meeting Him in our weakness, and not being afraid of what we encounter, and not avoiding what we see and running from that snake within us. But instead, we should encounter that snake and deal with all of those things and repent and go to confession. That's what confession is all about. It's like cauterizing a wound, right? And so I pray that you all find that stillness, because it's in that stillness that's the first step to a greater Christian faith, a greater relationship with Christ. We don't come to know Christ through books or theology or reading so-and-so saint. We come to know Christ through a still, small voice. May God give us strength and enlighten us through this silence and stillness. Glory to God. For yours is the kingdom of God, and glory, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Always and forever.
ascended into the heavens, and seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come again with glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom shall have no end. And then the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the Creator of life, who proceeds from the Father, who together with the Father and the Son was worshipped by the Father, who spoke to the prophets, in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Holy Church, I confess the baptism of the remission of sins, and look for the resurrection of the dead, and life for the age to come. Amen.
Sacrifices, to do as you have, what of these things can be used.
the cross, the tomb, and resurrection of the third day, the ascension to heaven, the enthronement of the right hand, and the second and glorious coming. Your own, of your own, we offer to you an honor and for the cycle song. Save us from them, cut the bond of Gaelic.
Once again, we offer to you the spiritual worship, which is without the second coming. We beseech you, pray, and entreat you. Send down your Holy Spirit upon us, upon these gifts we present. And make this bread the precious body of your Christ.
Amen.
And make this cup the precious blood of your Christ.
Amen.
Changing them by your Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
So that they may be for those who are taking them for vigilance of soul, remission of sins, communion of your Holy Spirit, fullness of the kingdom of heaven, boldness before you, not for judgment and condemnation. Again, we offer you the spiritual worship of those who have opposed the faith. Forefathers, fathers, patriarchs, prophets, apostles, preachers, evangelists, martyrs, professors, and saints, and for every righteous spirit, be perfect.
The
thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, to the ages of ages. The grace of best and all the mankind, your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed, together with your all the good and thy creating spirit, now and forever to the ages of ages.
Amen. Our God, Lord Jesus Christ, your God, from holy taught all Christ, with the throne of glory of your kingdom, and come to sanctify us, you who are enthroned with the Father our love, and are present among us and visibly here, and with your mighty hand grant communion of your most pure body. Precious blood to us, and through us all people. O God, be gracious in this sinner and mercy. God, be gracious in this sinner and mercy. O God, be gracious in this sinner and mercy.
Cleanse, O Lord, the filth of my soul and save me, as you are the one who loves mankind.
vows of the lost mankind, Lord Jesus Christ, my God, let not these holy gifts be to my judgment, because I am unworthy, but rather from the purification and sanctification of both soul and body, and the pledge of the life and kingdom to come. It is good for me to cleave unto God, and to place in Him the hope of my salvation. O Son of God, receive me today as a partaker of your mystical supper. For I will not speak of the mysteries of your enemies, nor will I give you kisses to Judas. Will I believe I confess you? Remember me, Lord, in your kingdom.
Thank you. From above, coming down from you, the Father. You may give glory and thanksgiving and worship to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and unto the ages of ages.
Life, the Lord, have mercy on us.
Wednesday at 11 a.m. study St. Polycarp's letter to the Philippians. It's a good one. It's a good letter. Glory to God. Thank you for having me today. And I was able to do a baptism yesterday, and we're going to do a wedding today. So what a full sacramental life we have here at Holy Trinity. And just a brief anecdote, my dad was actually the pastoral assistant here at St. Gonzalo's back from 93 to 99. And so if you think that Manuel sounds familiar, that's why. My dad is Father John Manuel.
Here.
He was here. Yes, he was at, he told me that he was at St. Gonzalo's as well, that he helped, but he was here, yes. So for me, this has been, I've gone back to my old house, and I've gone back to Milk and Honey, and I've seen where I used to ice cream. So it's a funny thing how the Lord works in our lives. Thank you to the chanters, Sala, it's not a beautiful job. And am I missing anything?
Just one thing, first of all, welcome.
Oh,
and second of all, I don't want to mention, for the Q&A session with Zoom, it's the same link that you can find on the website that we use for the Bible study. So that's where you can access for the Q&A. Any and all sorts of questions about any topic, we're going to be there to learn more about our faith and grow our relationship with Christ.
Beautiful. God bless you, and I believe the way we do it is we'll all come by and I'll just give you a blessing. That's how we do it in Akron, so all right, that's what I'll do. How about that? I'll just stand and I'll give you a blessing. So if you all want to put the ambulance on the back, I'm just kind of springing things on everybody. Glory to God. Glory to God.
Y'all ready?